Are you serious? Are you serious? Oh my, 34 people are dead. There may even be more in a botched robbery that took place in the Philippines at a casino yesterday. And already the Philippines are dealing with the fact they got a whole city that has been taken hostage by ISIS. And I still think there's a possibility that these robbers were part of ISIS. If they got their hands on enough cash, then they can pay an army. And as things continue to move forward. Well, anyway, at least 34 people are dead after gunmen burst into the Manila casino, firing shots and setting gaming tables alight. Philippine media reports that in which officials said was a botched robbery attempt. I'm not sure about that. Police said the unidentified gunman had killed himself after firing an armed officer's searching the still-smoking resorts of the World Manila Entertainment Complex hours after the drama that began shortly after midnight early this morning there in Philippines time. Many of the dead suffocated in the chaos as guests and staff tried to flee the choking smoke at the complex, according to the report of ANC News Channel, quoting the Bureau of Fire Protection sources. Are you serious? Resort owner and Travelers International Hotel Group said authorities were still seeking the details. We have been informed of several casualties, the number and identified of whom we have yet to be determined. It said in a statement, also, around dawn, the body of the suspected gunman was found in the hotel room in the complex, which is closed to the international airport and an Air Force base, very close to there. He burned himself inside the hotel room, room number 510, according to national police. He laid down on the bed, covered himself in a thick blanket, and apparently doused himself in gasoline. The bodies of two of the victims had been taken to the Veronica Funeral Parlor. And Reuters said there was more. Officials said at least 54 people are hurt, some very seriously, as they were rushed to escape what at first had been feared as a militant attack. Now, De La Rosa told DZMM Radio, the lone gunman, the only one guy did all this. I'm not buying this, guys. The same thing is with this Orlando nightclub. One guy killed 49 and wounded 50 and held the whole place hostage for 3 hours while SWAT teams couldn't get inside. This is, I'm talking Orlando, Florida. And it all came down to one guy, one guy. No, I'm not buying it. It's not real. You know, one guy can't kill and cause this much chaos. He can't, 34 people can't end up dead. 54 wounded, injured, from one guy who then managed to get out of there and get up to a hotel room 510. I mean, are you serious? Anyway, I'm sharing with you, this is not, you're going to find out, that this guy was linked somehow to radical terrorism, radical extremism, radical Islam, maybe. I would say probably radical Islam, and they'll link it and you'll find out. And maybe, or maybe they'll never tell us. Maybe they'll do just like they did the Orlando murderer. Maybe his father will be sitting behind Hillary Clinton during her campaign when she's running for president. How does the father of the guy that killed 50 people, 49, killed 49 people and wounded 50, how does this guy end up sitting two rows behind Secretary of State when she was running for President of the United States, Hillary Rodham Clinton? How does one guy hold off and pull that all off? How does one guy supposedly shoot and kill 11 people in Dallas, Texas, shoot 11 police officers, killing, I think, five of them? One guy. How does one guy do all that? I'm not buying it. These are coordinated efforts. These are attacks on the West. These are, right now, the Philippines is falling apart. ISIS sees that that the Philippines is in a state of chaos and they're trying to take some ground. They've already got a city of 200,000 people right now. The army can't get rid of the guys. Excuse me. Are you serious? I'm not buying it. I'm just not buying it. Give your life to Jesus Christ. He's the only hope.